The Truth About Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's Relationship. Number 23. How They Met. Meghan and Harry first made each other's acquaintance on a blind date at the beginning of July 2016.
They were introduced by a mutual friend of theirs who set them both up on a blind date together.
Despite the prince's global fame, Markle says she didn't really have any preconceived notions about who he was before they met. Meghan said, "Because I'm from the States, you don't grow up with the same understanding of the royal family. I didn't know much about him, so the only thing that I asked when my friend wanted to set us up was, is he nice? Because if he isn't kind, it just didn't seem to make sense." They both immediately hit it off. They met for a drink and then already started talking about making plans for the next day. Harry was asked when he knew that Meghan was the one, and he quickly replied with, "The very first time we met." After that, things moved along pretty quickly. They went on a second date, and then Harry invited Markle to come with him on a trip to Africa just a few weeks later. He managed to persuade her to go with him, and they had time alone with just the two of them under the stars, which was crucial to Harry to make sure they clicked well and got a chance to know each other. For 22. First Dating Rumors. Millions of ordinary people dream about what it would be like to date and marry a royal, but only a select few ever do. This is why the world was captivated when Prince Harry started dating the actress, and the excitement went through the roof when they announced their engagement in November 2017. They had been secretive about their relationship, but it was clear that the two of them were head over heels for each other. Rumors of the two dating started in October 2016. People went totally crazy when the country's single prince was dating an American actress and blogger, Meghan Markle. Friends and family said Harry is happier than he's been in years with his new lady love. Number 21. Deal or No Deal. Before landing her gig on the show Suits, Meghan got her start as a model on the well-known game show holding the mysterious briefcase, Deal or No Deal. Number 20. News got out. After 4 months of dating under the radar, the news finally leaked on October 31st, 2016, that Prince Harry was dating an American actress. Harry is happier than he's been in years with Meghan. The same day that Harry said that, Meghan posted a photo on her Instagram page of two bananas spooning, maybe hinting at the new love in her life. They had a good 6 months of privacy with just the two of them before the world started bombarding them. Number 19. Who's older?
A little fun fact, Meghan is actually 3 years older than her lover.
She was born August 4th, 1981, and Harry in 1984. Number 18. Harry defends his girlfriend. Harry confirmed his relationship with Meghan with a formal statement on November 8th, 2016. He also pleads the press and internet trolls on social media to stop the wave of abuse and harassment that has been directed at his girlfriend. Harry has been involved with nightly legal battles to put a stop to the media about publishing false stories about Meghan and their relationship. Harry said in an interview that he and Meghan were both taken back by the harshness of the media and were totally surprised by the reaction. Most people would think that Markle would be prepared for the attention because she has been in the public eye as an actress, but not much could prepare her for what was to come. She said, "There was a misconception that because I have worked in the entertainment industry, that this would be something I would be familiar with. But I've never been part of the tabloid culture. I've never been in pop culture to that degree and lived a relatively quiet life." At the beginning of the relationship, Meghan chose not to read any of the things that were posted or said about her, positive or negative. Instead, they focused all of their energy on nurturing their relationship. Number 17. Prince William weighs in. Prince William released a statement on November 27, 2016, to clear up rumors that he was not happy with his brother's decision to open up about his relationship. Part of the statement reads, "The Duke of Cambridge absolutely understands the situation concerning privacy and supports the need for Prince Harry to support those closest to him." Number 16. The Queen approves. The Queen is fully supportive, and a source revealed that the Queen is delighted to see Harry in a loving relationship. Meghan talked about meeting the Queen, and she said, "It's incredible to be able to meet her through his lens, not just with his honor and respect for her as the monarch, but the love that he has for her as his grandmother. She's an incredible woman." They spent Christmas with their own families and spent New Year's together in London. Number 15. Meghan's family. Meghan's half-brother, Thomas Markle Jr., told the Daily Mail that their father has known about their relationship since the beginning. Thomas says his father is pretty happy with Harry and very proud of her. Meghan is very close with her family and also attended her mother's graduation from the University of Southern California when she received her master's in social work in 2016. Number 14. A romantic trip to Norway.
After the two of them spent New Year's in London together, they left for a romantic getaway to Norway.
This is the first time they went on a vacation together. Harry planned the romantic trip so that they could catch the northern lights. While they were there, they stayed with a close friend of Harry's. He put a lot of thought into the whole trip and wanted to make it as romantic and special as possible. Number 13. Meeting Kate and Charlotte. In early 2017, Harry introduced Meghan to his sister-in-law, Kate Middleton, and Princess Charlotte at the Kensington Palace. Kate and Meghan got along fabulously. Number 12. Long-distance relationship. Meghan filmed her USA Network series called Suits in Toronto, Canada. She and Harry were seen holding hands while leaving West London Soho House. The couple tried to remain low-key by sitting in the corner of the restaurant. restaurant. They are head over heels for each other and can't bear to be apart. After taking a 2-month break from social media, Markle posted an Instagram photo saying, "No bad energy." In March 2017, they traveled to Jamaica to attend one of Harry's childhood friend's wedding. In April, Harry flew from England to spend Easter weekend with Meghan in Toronto. Number 11. Meghan's life starts to change. She announced that she would shut down her lifestyle website, which she had founded for 3 years. It's been rumored that she shut down her passion project because of her royal relationship, but a source has said the real reason is her busy schedule and balancing shooting her TV series and doing charity work. Number 10. Meghan meets the royal dad. Meghan met Harry's dad, and the couple told him that an engagement was a possibility for the two of them. There was no word on what Harry's dad thought of Meghan, but we're sure he was charmed. Number 9. The couple steps out. Harry and Markle made their first public appearance as a couple and also kissed in public at the annual Audi Polo Challenge in England. Harry participated in the games while Meghan was wearing a navy dress and white blazer cheering her prince on from the sidelines.
They were later seen engaging in some PDA in the Polo parking lot.
Number 8. A big birthday trip. The busy couple traveled to Africa in August 2017 for a romantic getaway for Meghan's 36th birthday. They stayed for 3 weeks and visited Botswana and finished their trip at the beautiful Victoria Falls. Number 7. Harry gifted half a painting. Prince Harry has purchased a piece of artwork from a British artist. The painting is called Everybody Needs Somebody to Love. He said he purchased it for a special person back in October 2016. So we're just going to assume that the gesture was for Meghan, since they started dating around the same time. He also asked if the painting could be split in 2 pieces. Sounds like he wants each of them to have a piece hanging in their own homes. Number 6. Meghan opens up. Meghan openly spoke about her relationship for the first time in October 2017 in an issue of Vanity Fair. She said, "We're a couple. We're in love. I'm sure there will be a time when we have to come forward and present ourselves and have stories to tell. But I hope what people will understand is that this is our first time. This is for us. It's part of what makes it so special that's just ours. But we're happy. Personally, I love a great love story." That same month, she accompanied Harry to an official royal appearance for the first time at the Invictus Games opening ceremony. Over the course of the games, cameras caught them holding hands and spending time with Meghan's mother. At this point, Harry has met Meghan's mother several times, and they get along great. Number 5. Moving in together. It has been reported that Meghan basically moved in with Harry while Meghan was on a break filming for her show. It's been said that she moved in with Harry to his place, an apartment on the grounds of Kensington Palace, which is also Prince William and Kate's home. A few days later, it was reported that the basement in the palace would be redone for the two of them to permanently move in. But later on, papers were drawn up showing that the renovation was for office space and a dress collection instead. Number 4. Harry gifted her a ring. Meghan was seen wearing a gold ring, but don't get too excited just yet. This one is for her thumb. Just a gift from him, and of course she bragged to her castmates all about how he got it for her, just as any girl would. As for the engagement ring, the night he proposed, they were just having a cozy night with just the two of them. They were trying to roast a chicken for dinner. Nothing fancy. Then he popped the question. Meghan said, "It was just an amazing surprise. It was so sweet and natural and very romantic." Number 3. Meghan's siblings and a strange sister. Meghan's mom and dad divorced when she was just 6 years old. She has one full brother and a half-brother named Thomas Markle Grand Jr. She also has an older sister, but they're not very close. Her sister's name is Samantha, and she is shopping a tell-all story about what it was like growing up with Meghan. Samantha said a little in the past, saying, "Hollywood has changed her. I think her ambition is to become a princess." The truth would kill her relationship with Prince Harry. Number 2. They continue to grow closer. At the beginning of December 2016, Meghan was photographed in Toronto wearing a gold necklace with the letters M and the letter H. The necklace was created by a jewelry designer in California and cost $240.
Later that month, they were seen picking out a Christmas tree together.
And in London's West End, holding hands on their way to see the Tony Award-winning show, The Curious Incident of the Dog in the Nighttime. According to a source, they walked through the Soho area while looking at Christmas lights. Number 1. Married. After Harry and Meghan announced their plans to marry on November 27th of last year, Prince Harry proposed with a ring he designed, which he made using one diamond from Botswana and 2 smaller stones from Princess Diana's collection. During the wedding ceremony, the bride and groom exchanged rings made by Cleve & Company. Meghan's ring was made out of Welsh gold, and Harry's ring is a platinum band. The wedding took place on May 19th, 2018 at 12 p.m. noon. It was held at the St. George's Chapel at Windsor Castle. Immediately after they exchanged their vows, the newly married couple took a carriage ride through Windsor. On the wedding day, Meghan traveled to the castle in a car through the procession route with her mother Doria by her side. The designer that created Meghan's wedding dress also created her shoes for the big day. Typically, the royal wedding cakes are fruitcakes, but Meghan and Harry are bucking tradition. They had a lemon elderflower cake. The bride wore Queen Mary's diamond bandeau for her wedding day look. After the ceremony, they took the carriage back to Buckingham Palace, where the Queen hosted a lunch for 650 guests. Later that evening, they enjoyed a reception for their closest friends and family inside the palace. Hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.